ओए मैं क्यों ऑन किया?
Good afternoon, everyone. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you very much. Just a minute. Let me share the screen. I hope all of you have joined. Yes. Okay. Okay. Is it visible to everyone?
No. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Good. So, in this numerical, what I discussed in a previous class, I hope there is no problem. Right? Is it fully okay to everyone? All the slaves?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Very good.
Yes, sir.
So, today we will learn.
Sign direction. Yes? Sign direction, sir. Samajh mein nahi aaya.
Okay. Let me tell you again. Okay. Suppose this one is a resistor. Okay. Resistor or inductor or capacitor. If current flows in this direction. Okay. I am writing here. Is it visible to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Good. So, if the current is flowing in the direction I am showing here, then this side will be positive, this side will be negative. That means loss in potential. Okay? Correct? So, that's why it is called the voltage drop. Okay? I am writing here VD. It is called voltage drop because this is loss in potential, and if the current flow direction is opposite, then this side will be positive, this side will be negative. Now accordingly our equation will get changed. Right? Now when we are considering the bigger loop, okay, this outer loop, when R1 is considered, R2 is considered, this voltage source, so what type of voltage source? Yes, speak again.
So voice not clear.
Okay, is it clear now?
No, sir.
Okay, so here, then just leave the meeting and then again join. Okay, maybe some problem is there.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Okay, so we are considering here this 10 volt independent voltage source, this R1, R2, and this 20 volt. Okay, now we are going to create that equation. Okay, the last equation. here this one is positive, this one is negative. So if we see the direction of our movement, okay, this blue line, this outer blue line, it is the direction of our movement for the outer loop. Now just a minute, bolun sir,
kon se shuru
dutu 40 10 what will be our positive and negative polarity? This side will be positive, this side will be negative for this R1 resistor. So this one is loss in potential, correct? So I am writing here 10 into R1 because it is the voltage drop across the R1, correct? Next, check the current direction here. The current direction is I2. The current direction is in anticlockwise. So this side will be positive, this side will be negative. So if you move, then you are gaining the potential. That means we will write here plus 20 R2. Okay. 20 into R2. Now, here is the independent voltage source. Okay. Now, you are moving from positive to negative. That means what? You are losing the potential. That's why we will write here minus 20 equal to 0. That's how we always create the equation according to the movement of the current, right? Is it clear to everyone? Okay, I don't know who is asking, yes, but is it clear to everyone?
Or yes,
do I need
yes,
to explain? Okay,
yes, sir.
Very good. So now what we will learn today, it is called mesh current analysis. I told you that there are several types of calculation by which we can calculate the current, we can calculate the voltage as per our requirement. Okay, it is one process, mesh current analysis. Another one is node analysis or nodal voltage analysis. Okay, these two will be discussed today. So what is in mesh current analysis? What is mesh? This loop analysis or mesh analysis, this, if we move in this direction or in this direction, okay, or the direction we draw, suppose someone is going in this direction, okay, anti-clockwise direction, but you don't want that, you want to move by the clockwise direction. Don't worry, both will give the same answer every time. Okay, whatever be the direction you choose, your calculation will be changed, but your ultimate answer will remain same every time. Okay. Okay, fine. So we are going to solve this numerical using the mesh current analysis or loop current analysis. Why we are calling it loop analysis? Because see, what is a loop? A loop is a closed circuit where the elements are considered only once. Okay, so here check, this R1 is taken into consideration for one time, R3 also one time, this voltage also one time. And always remember, this type of voltage source is called the independent voltage source. Okay, this is not dependent. Two types of voltage sources I discussed, right? One is independent, another one is dependent. Again, another two types of voltage sources are there, AC voltage source and DC voltage source. Here, mesh current analysis, nodal analysis, all will be discussed based on the DC voltage source, right? So here, this circuit is redrawn below, mentioning its current flow. Okay, here I am considering the current flow as in clockwise manner. Check this I1, I2, both are in clockwise. Okay, this inside current, you have to check now the inside current. Okay, now what we will do? We will create the equations now for each loop. Right, now see here how many number of variables are present if we consider the loop. How many loops are there? Can you say? How many loops are there in this circuit? Anyone speak?
Three, sir. Two.
Yes.
Three.
Two.
Three.
How three? Here only two loops are present, right? Inside loop.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
In earlier case, what we discussed here, I am saying what? This is outer path. Okay, I am not telling anytime this is a loop. I am telling every time that this is the outer loop. I am mentioning every time that this is outer loop. Okay, but when we call that how many number of loops are present in a circuit, we will see every time that inside how many loops are possible, so that one number of element may get considered only once. Right, so here only two loops are present, and in each case we will generate the equations. Okay, step by step. So first, when we consider this loop, okay, suppose I am naming this loop one and this one is loop two, right? Now, how to create these equations? Okay, let me show the loop again. Okay, okay, for the loop one, just one person, tell me what will be the equation.
Ten minus ten I one.
Then what should I write?
Plus 20 I minus 20 equal to 0.
No. You are considering then this one 40 also.
Plus 40 I3.
Plus 40.
Very
plus 40 I3.
Minus
40 I3. 40 I3. Hmm,
correct. That will be minus 40. Wait. Here there is one thing you should know. Okay. Through this 40 ohm resistor, how many number of currents are flowing in this direction?
Oh.
I1 current is flowing. Very good.
Sir, two
number of currents are flowing.
Two, sir.
One is
two.
I1 and second one is I2.
I2.
Okay. Very good. So here, what will be our net current through that 40 ohm, because two loops I have considered here, I3 is not present. We are not considering here I3. We are not considering here branch. We are considering here the loop, right? What is branch? If you move along this line, okay, then it is called branch. But where is loop? Loop is a closed path. Okay, so in that loop, we are considering I1 current is flowing, and in this loop, I2 current is flowing. So through this 40 ohm resistor, what is the net current flowing? According to our movement is along I1. So what is our net current?
I1
minus I2 within bracket equals to zero. Okay, now tell me, is it understandable to everyone or not? Then I will repeat
yes,
again.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Very good. So according to our movement in that loop, we will check what is the voltage drop and what is our polarity, correct? So again, we will check according to the polarity. Our polarity is now rising, that's why positive. Then this is voltage drop. So our polarity gets changed. It is decreasing, that's why minus 10i. Again here, polarity is decreasing. According to our movement, the total current flowing through this 40 ohm is I1 minus I2. So what will be the voltage drop? 40 into I1 minus I2, correct? And since the voltage drop is opposite, voltage drop is from positive to negative, that means you are dropping the potential. That's why this negative sign is present here. So this is your first equation. Clear? So now calculate this one. This value will be 10 equals to 10i1, 40i1. It will be 50 into i1. Then plus 40i2. And when we move that to the right hand side, this will be minus 40i2. Now check this equation you just got. This one. Okay. It is matching now. Now for I2, now we will consider the second loop. Okay. So let me erase all this. Okay, so now what will happen? What is our movement? Always check your movement in the loop. Okay, your movement is along the I2. And how this I2 is going through this loop? It is in clockwise direction. Okay, so let me draw the potential first. Plus, minus, okay? Never consider this I1, I2. This one is for the previous. Now, we are considering only two variables, I1 and I2. Check that. What is the difference between what we are doing and what was done in the previous? In previous case, three variables are present. I1, I2, I3. But here, two variables are present, I1 and I2. Is it clear? What is the difference between mesh current and our normal process that was done earlier? Okay. So now, according to the movement of I2, we are going from positive to negative. So our potential drop is present, that is minus 20. Clear, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, according to the I2 movement, you are moving through this 40 ohm and your potential is rising, correct? So I will put here positive sign, right? 40. Now inside what should I write? This one is the 40 ohm resistor. Current I2 is flowing. Current I1 is opposing. So here, current flow will be I2 minus I1. Okay, this was clear to everyone why I2 minus I1 is present, multiplied with 40.
Sir, could you explain this again?
Okay, fine. This is your 40 ohm resistor. Okay, I2 current is flowing and I1 current is opposite, right? So what is your net current flowing through this 40 ohm? That is I2 minus I1, correct?
Yes, sir.
And due to the current flow, voltage drop is also present. And the when this type of current is flowing in this direction, then what is your potential? This side will be positive and this side will be negative, correct? When current is flowing, na? This current is flowing, so your potential is dropping. So here minus sign will be done. I have done here wrong, but none of you are telling me that, sir, you are doing this wrong. See, when you are studying this basic electrical now, always stay open-minded, okay? What you are doing, there is always one explanation, right? So our potential is dropping here. That's why minus sign will be present. Clear? This sign plus and minus, what was done? That was depending on I1, not depending on I2. Please make it sure every time. Okay. Now when I2 current is flowing, that means the I2 current is flowing through this 20 ohm by this direction. So that means our potential is again dropping. So minus 20 I2. Okay. So now reconstruct this equation. What will be the reconstruction? Reconstructed equation. I am keeping minus 20 in left hand side and all other part I am putting in right hand side. Okay, now check what is happening there. 40 I1 here is plus. So this side I will get 40 I1 as minus, correct? Then plus 60 I2. Okay. Now check here. The second equation you just got. Okay. Now is it clear to everyone? Or do I need to again explain this? Hello, is it understandable?
Sir, your voice is not clear.
Everyone?
Sir, voice is breaking.
Okay. Okay, okay, okay. Just a minute. Okay, now is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. Okay, so is it clear to everyone how this second equation is formed using the second loop?
Yes, sir.
Because according to second loop, our rotation is different. Okay, so according to that rotation, we have to create the sign. We have to write the sign. Okay, just a minute. Now, according to this rotation, your potential is dropping for the source. That's why minus 20 volt is present here. Okay. When I2 is flowing in this direction through the 40 ohm, then what will be your positive and what side will be negative? The lower side will be positive, upper side will be negative. Okay. That means your potential is again dropping here. That's why minus sign is present. Okay, and what is your net current through this 40 ohm? I2 current is going, but I1 current is opposing. That's why I2 minus I1 I need to write, and it is multiplied here. Again, I2 current is flowing through the 20 ohm resistor in this direction because your rotation is like this. Okay, rotation is like clockwise direction. So again, this side is positive, this side is negative. So potential is dropping and minus 20 I2 is present in the equation. Now reconstruct that equation, you will get minus 20 equal to minus 40 into I1 plus 60 I2. So two equations you have. Now it is very easy for you to calculate the I1 and I2. Okay, now here the matrix multiplication is done, right? Now if you are doing by matrix multiplication or you are doing by the equation solving method in normal process, both will give you the correct answer. Okay, check, the I1 value is present, I2 value is present. Okay, so your I1 value you know, and I2 direction it is already given. Now from here also you can calculate the I3 direction. Okay, when you have this minus sign, that means your direction you have to mention every time. Okay, I1's magnitude is 0.143 but direction is in opposite. Okay, suppose I am writing here, this is A point, this is B point, and in between that 40 ohm or 10 ohm according to this question is present, and this is the I1 according to the loop because I1 current is flowing like this. So what will I write? If you write that I1 current magnitude equals to 0.143, okay, and direction is B to A. Okay, then your answer is correct. Or if you don't want to write that, you may write this one also. I1 value is minus 0.143 ampere. Both are equally correct. Okay, here this minus sign is already saying that your direction, what is present according to the question, is the not the right direction, it is the opposite direction. Okay, so that is the meaning. Both this one is correct, this one is also correct. So anyone can write either of these two. Okay, now next is the node voltage analysis. This one is very easy. How? Because here at every point we consider the voltage. Okay, KCL law is applied. KCL law means Kirchhoff's current law. Okay, what is node? Node is that point where two or three elements are connected or branches are meeting. That point is called a node. Here, check, this 10 ohm resistor is connected with this 10 volt source at this point. So we can say this is one node. Okay, when 10 ohm, 20 ohm and 40 ohm are connected at this point, so we can say this is also another node, correct? And also this one another node. Now what is this? This is called reference line. This is called reference line. Okay, so in exam, it may be asked that how many nodes are present in the system. Okay, so at that time, if you wrote there are 4 nodes present in the system, including this one, then you are wrong. Okay, total 3 nodes are present and 1 is reference. Clear?
Now, so bottom one is reference or node?
Bottom line means it is 0 volt line. Bottom line is always called the 0 volt line. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Clear, everyone? Okay,
yes,
fine.
Yes, sir.
So now, how to solve this question? Here, we will solve what? According to the Kirchhoff's current law. Now, what is the Kirchhoff's current law? At one node, the total incoming current equals to the total outgoing current. Or we can say the summation of the current at a node is always 0. So here, through this branch, I am drawing the I1 current is flowing. Here, I2 current is flowing. Here, I3 current is flowing. So, we can say that, if you don't agree, then you may question me, okay? Because whatever I am doing here, whatever you are listening, all are based on the logic. Okay. Now, according to Kirchhoff's current law, what is the incoming current? I1 and I2. At this node, we are talking about.
So your voice is lagging.
This node. Okay. And what is the outgoing current? I3. Okay, that may be due to the internet problem. Okay, where you cannot hear me, just let me know. Okay, I will repeat again. No issue. But I am. Maybe it is due to the internet connection. So if you cannot understand, just let me know where you cannot understand, where you couldn't listen. Okay. So here, okay, is my voice clear now? Is my voice clear now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Right now.
Yes, sir.
Hello, student. Okay. So according to Kirchhoff's current law, at this point, this N node, I am writing, what is your incoming current? I1. And your outgoing current? I3. Okay. Now, in place of this I1, can I write 10 minus VB?
Sir, voice not proper.
Divided by 10. Can I write this? Okay, is it okay now?
Yes, sir.
Sir, repeat it again.
Is it okay? Is it clear to everyone? Okay. So here, 10 volt is here. And at, okay, at this. So at this N node, I am assuming that voltage is VB. Okay. So can I write this instead of I1, 10 minus VB by 10, can I write this? because this is your resistance. Okay, at this point your voltage is 10. Okay, and at this point your voltage is VB. So what is the value of current that will flow through this resistor? That will be simply 10 minus VB divided by 10, right? Okay, now instead of I2, I can write this 20 minus VB divided by 20. Okay, clear? Because in case of 20 ohm, check everyone, this point voltage is 20. This point's voltage is VB. And current direction is this. And the resistance is 20. So we can write this 20 minus VB by 20. Okay, that is I2. Now what is I3? I am telling you that this reference line voltage is always 0 volt. Okay, so I can write this VB minus 0 divided by 40. Okay, is it clear to everyone?
Is yes,
this construction is clear? Okay, very good. Then please check here that only one variable is present in nodal analysis, node voltage analysis, right? So if you can calculate this one, you will get the magnitude of VB. Okay? Okay, everyone, please calculate what is the value of VB. I just want to know. Everyone, calculate the value of VB and please tell me what is the value. Now, from here, you can calculate either I1 or I2 or I3. Okay, because VB by 40 will give you I3 value. Okay, 10 minus VB minus 10, this will give you I1 value, and 20 minus VB by 20 will give you I2 value. So it is much more easier to solve since you are calculating with only one variable here. Okay, if you do the mesh analysis, then there you have to take the two variables for two loops for this circuit only. Okay, and for the same circuit, if you do the nodal voltage analysis using the Kirchhoff's current law, then check that only one voltage VB is present in the system. So if you calculate the VB, you can get any value I1, I2 or I3. Okay, clear to everyone? So now see, what is the VB value? VB value is 80 by 7 volt. Okay,
yes sir.
Now VB value is known to you. Okay, is it correct?
Yes sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, very
yes,
good.
Sir, yes sir. 11.4.
I3 you can calculate, that is 0.286. Correct. So now you can check with the previous numericals, previous process, okay, that this value is correct. And now you can check the difference that this nodal voltage analysis is taking much less time.
Yes.
With respect to the mesh analysis and the our normal method, branch method. Okay. So that is simply the Kirchhoff's circuit law, the application of Kirchhoff's circuit law, this nodal voltage analysis. Okay, so two types of equation, two types of process is discussed today. Okay, and it is almost 2:45. Okay, we still have 5 minutes time. Okay, now this one is the lecture 4. Okay, DC circuit. Here we will learn the resistive voltage divider, current divider circuit and Thevenin's theorem. I already told you that total three theorems will be discussed as per your syllabus. Okay, Thevenin's theorem, Norton's theorem, and the superposition theorem. Okay, what is the basic need of the using of this theorem? To make the circuit small so that we can calculate the current very easily. Okay, and you also can perform those Thevenin theorem and Norton theorem in lab also. Okay, we will also show you how to calculate those values. Okay, whatever calculation you will do in copy, that value will show in ammeter also. Right, now what is the resistive voltage divider circuit? It is nothing but your basic concept. When current flows through the resistor, okay, suppose this direction, this side will be positive, this side will be negative, right? So that is just drawn here. Okay, Vs voltage is here, okay, and this is one node, and in between Vs and zero, R1 is connected, and this V0 to zero, this is your always reference. So have you seen one green color or black color where is red, another one is green or black? Okay, that green or black where
voice is lagging, sir.
Yes. Okay. Actually, internet problem is here, no? So that's why this voice is lagging. Okay. So at your home, you will see that in a connection, one where of color green or black is always present. Okay. That voltage, that wire is called the ground wire. Okay, or neutral wire. You may ask your parent that why two types of wire is present.
Oh, earthing, right, sir?
Okay, one wire is called a live, another wire is called the neutral wire. Okay, that one is show you. Just take a note. Okay, that I have to discuss what is the difference between the neutral wire and ground wire. Okay, just make a note. And I also told you that I will discuss why the train, why the fan's direction can be changed. Okay, that will be discussed, but today I am having a little bit more. Okay, just anyone make a note and please remind me, okay, in next class. So this is the resistive voltage divider circuit. Okay, so this one is the, what is the voltage that is developed across the R1, that is I into R1, correct? That is the VR1. Okay, mute yourself. Okay, so here, what is the voltage developed across this R1, that is I into R1, and what is the voltage developed across this R2, that is I into R2. So the total voltage difference will be equal to the voltage drop. So that's why Vs minus 0 equal to VR1 plus VR2, right? And VR1 equals to I into R1, that is simple, and VR2 equals to I into R2. So we can write in place of Vs I into R1 plus R2. This is the total current I, Vs divided by R1 plus R2. Okay. Now for resistive voltage divider circuit, it is very easy to calculate what is the value of I, because also R1 and R2 are connected in series. So total current is Vs by R1 plus R2. That is basic concept of resistive voltage divider circuit. Now your work is how to calculate this VR1 value and VR2 value. Okay, what is VR2? I into R2. So in place of I, put the whole value Vs by R1 plus R2. And what is VR1? That is Vs into R1 by R1 plus R2. That is basic. Okay, this one is basic calculation that already we had done in the previous numericals, right? So this is the voltage divider circuit. Okay, so I am concluding the today's class with this resistive voltage divider circuit. Okay, every one of you give your attendance in the chat box. Okay, and if you have any query, you may ask. Okay, and from next class, from this part, we will discuss the resistive current divider circuit. Right. Now, everyone give your attendance in my personal, in the chat box. And if you have given your attendance, you may leave the meeting. Okay. So thank you, everyone. Thank you. And if you have any query, you may ask. Thank you, everyone.
So please provide the notes, sir.
Yes, I already had uploaded PPT 1 and PPT 2. PPT 3 will be uploaded today. Okay.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you, everyone.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.